We're at the Twin Brook Hilton in Rockville, Maryland, for the Capital Audiofest 2022. I'm Howard Neller, and welcome to The Listening Chair.
Hey, Howard, I'm Matt from VPI Industries. I'm excited to have you here to check out what we've got today.
Thanks, Matt. Appreciate it.
This is our new state-of-the-art $36,000 direct drive turntable. It's based off of the Avenger class, which gives it the ability to be a complete sandbox experience for the user. So with the tone arm, you can mount up to three arms, any length, in any model. Of course, we hope you pick a VPI, but at the end of the day, it's your listening experience. And VPI is trying to create that enjoyable moment for you all, so you can take it and own it. So whether it's a 9-inch, 10-inch, 12-inch tone arm, gimbal, unipivot, or whatever it is you like, VPI is ready to give you the experience for your listening room.
And the flexibility.
That's right.
Very nice. And what kind of arms do you have on it? You said...
So right now we're showcasing the latest of our 3D Fat Boy tone arms. So fortunately, with our company, we always have the ability of trickle-down technology and staying on the cutting edge of engineering and what's happening. So the tone arm itself is totally dead. It gets out of the way of the cartridge and lets it do its job.
Okay.
Speaking of the cartridge, we have a really exciting experience here because you are seeing and soon be hearing the world debut of the VPI Goldie cartridge.
Oh, congratulations. So what kind of cartridge is it?
It's a moving coil cartridge, and you may remember the Shiloh cartridge, which we released right here in this room 3 years ago. I'm losing my mind. It's been a long year.
Right. But I do remember that.
Yeah. So right here we launched the Shiloh, named after my daughter Shiloh. So here we are. Yesterday was my daughter's 2-year birthday, and so we named it after her.
Congratulations.
The VPI Goldie.
And how much is the Goldie?
The Goldie is going to retail for $1,200.
Okay. Very nice. And I think I was reading something about you had developed it with another company.
Yes. So we've been working very closely with Audio-Technica. What's really nice about them is they'll work with you. They'll talk, and they won't try to influence it. We have the baseline. In this case, the baseline model is the OC9 class.
Okay.
But then from the voicing, we feel, myself, Harry, all of us when listening, the mid-range. This dialogue right now, this is what you listen to every day. If you nail the mid-range, then you just nail that natural sound where you can close your eyes and just really feel like you're just in the music and you're really there. So when working with Audio-Technica, we voiced it and made changes within the internal design of it so that it would be geared towards the mid-range. So giving us a cartridge that nails it on the lows, a nice punch, gives you the details on the highs, that gives you that natural mid-range so you close your eyes and you forget that you're in a listening room with two speakers.
Now, I guess Audio-Technica, they've made a few cartridges themselves. So if somebody might be wondering, why would they come to VPI?
Now, that's a really good question because I had that same question when they came to us. It had to have been about 5-6 years now. They came to us asking to use a version of this table, our Avenger Plus. It was when we launched the table. So I had to ask them, guys, what are you doing? You make turntables. They were launching their Art 1000 cartridge. And they said that they really wanted to get into the high end and have a turntable that had the diversity to have multiple arms and flexibility with the cartridge. So that's what they did. They took the Avenger Plus, they mounted three arms, and I know that sounds crazy. Imagine this with three arms. Two arms
visually works. Right.
Three arms gets a little wacky, but they did it. And they showed the Art 9, they showed the Art 1000. I don't remember what the third cartridge was.
Okay.
And they loved that experience so much that we just kept doing things together. Then we had the conversation of doing a tone arm together, and it went from there. So, and now, even more exciting, and you'll get to see it a little bit later, we're actually going to be the first to showcase their 60th anniversary cartridge.
And do you have that here?
Yes, it's on the way, and Okay. Actually, they're coming right from Japan. So they're going to be coming and handing it to us probably within the next hour or two.
Great. Now, I just attended the 60th anniversary function for Audio-Technica at the Turntable LP and Karaoke Bar. So I know a little about the 60th anniversary celebration, and I think the 60th anniversary cartridge is a pretty pricey one, right?
Oh, it certainly is. It's up there, I believe, in the $9,000 range, which is a completely different stratosphere than you'd usually see from Audio-Technica.
Awesome, awesome. Well, that's a great vote of confidence from a company like Audio-Technica.
So we got the arm all set. It's waiting for us to mount it. So
with the Goldie?
That's right. So we're going to have the Goldie as our main arm to utilize. And then we got to put the expensive stuff in the back just to keep the people at the show from getting a little wacky over here.
Okay.
So we're showcasing the Goldie in this room, and then in the other room we'll have our Shiloh cartridge. And in the back, we're going to be the first in America to showcase their anniversary cartridge. And we're so excited, we're probably going to buy it.
That's very cool. We're going to come back and take a look at that. What? Maybe you can just walk me quickly through the system.
Sure. So the rest of the system, so we, of course, starting at the source at the moment. Actually, let me lift this guy really fast. There we go. We've got our Goldie cartridge by Audio-Technica right through our Fatboy tone arm in our new, actually, this is something to talk about too, our Fatboy VTA bass.
Right.
This was a technological advancement that came from our anniversary table, but now we've made it with an adapter so it can fit on any VPI with a 12-inch mount. So then from there, of course, the table itself is our Avenger Direct, using our direct drive technology, which we've seen in our anniversary table, and again, just award-winning all around. Phono stage-wise, we are going through Audio Research, as well as the Audio Research preamp, and two Audio Research monoblocks. So actually, these are the same electronics from Audio Research that we used last year at the show. It was supposed to be borrowing it and hanging out, and we liked it so much that we couldn't let them have it back. So these are now regulars over in the VPI house if you ever come up to Jersey. Now, the circulatory system of this is all Nordost cable. So lots of silver over here.
Right.
So we've got a Made in America turntable, electronics, and then the cabling through and through.
Which model of the Nordost are you using?
I believe we've got the Odin.
It looks like the Odin from here.
Yeah. Yeah, so
that's
about
pretty unmistakable looking.
Yeah, it's about the price of a car lying down on its side, you know, because that's totally normal.
Although cars are pretty expensive these days.
That's
also
true.
Yeah.
So then at the end of the chain, we're really excited to have the Tannoy Canterbury speakers.
Right.
Now, what inspired this years ago, because we all know Harry, my dad, he found a pair of Tannoy memory speakers, the old ones. We actually showed them at the New York show about 8 years ago,
okay,
when we debuted the VPI Prime, my first turntable, and the memories were so good. We've been using it, and I mean, they're what, like 30, 40 years old, and we just keep on using those speakers. And then not too long ago, we're like, well, what's Tannoy up to now? We saw the Tannoys up on over with Kevin Deal, since I believe he's bringing them in.
The Kevin Deal over at Upscale Audio.
That's right. You know, so Kevin Deal has been bringing these in. And he's one of our dealers and one of our good partners over here in the U.S. And he was excited. I know he's rocking an Avenger Direct over in his listening room. And now we're rocking an Avenger Direct and his Tannoy Canterbury speakers right here. So
that's awesome. Do you know the retail on the speakers?
I believe it's $34,000, give or take. But, hey, what's a few thousand amongst friends?
Absolutely, especially these days.
Yeah, exactly. So we're really excited and proud of this system. I mean, we just fired it up, and these guys have been, they're starting to break in nicely, and we're really looking forward to having a great show and a great music experience for everybody.
That's awesome. I mean, one thing I've noticed, you know, VPI tables have never been made shoddily, but I can see you guys are really ratcheting up the build quality on these things.
100%. You know, it's just been getting better and better. We've been very fortunate by just having some of the best partners of different manufacturers. And I don't even call them a machine shop, because everyone's part of the VPI family.
Right.
So whether it's our woodworker, whether it's our machinist, or whoever it is, everyone's part of the VPI family. And we just take a lot of pride in what we make and do. And the past couple of years have been rough for everybody, but for us, we've taken it as an opportunity to just go even further and just open that window to success.
Excellent. Well, we really appreciate it. Maybe we can hear a few bars of music.
That sounds like a pretty great idea.
Great.